welcome to another edition of Koffee and Kramer. It is Joey Kramer.
And I'm Jennifer Koffee.
And we are Koffee and Kramer. It is the Christmas edition of Koffee and Kramer because I highly doubt we're going to find time before Christmas to do another podcast.
Sure, we might.
Maybe we'll do one on Christmas Eve.
Maybe there'll be a snow day and we'll have time.
Maybe there'll be a snow day, but if it's not, this might be the last podcast until...
the new year?
Maybe until the new year. I'm not sure.
Our lives are really hectic right now.
Tell me about it. We have basketball, 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 basketball. I have more basketball now than when...
well, there's cookie making and there's presents to
wrap. When they were little, I don't think I ran as much for sports as I do now.
You're correct. We do run more.
At age 39.
But we run like four schedules is why.
It's crazy.
Instead of one or two.
I have my freshman girls team. We have our JV team. Our eighth grade team. And we have our varsity team. And this year, because of some people, we're doing double leagues. And plus, we have to beat all the games. So we have
We have our daughter still playing.
Yeah, well, that's...
so, well, she
does. I ain't
doing
any more of those there's no point if she's...
well, but I'm just saying she's still playing. So
anyway, when you coach the freshman game at 4:15, you then have to stay for the JV game and sit on the bench for that game at 6 o'clock, and then of course the varsity game at 7:30. So yesterday we left the house at 3 o'clock and we got home around 10.
I left at 7 in the morning and got home at 10.
Here's the question I have, and for guys that are listening, one guy to another.
It is hard to be a female.
Exactly. How did you know I was going to say that? Why is it so difficult to be a woman?
It is hard to be a female.
Why is it so difficult to be a woman? Guys do the same thing and we don't complain about it.
I don't know if that's exactly true.
It is.
All you do is complain about it.
I mean, we've been together for so long. I've dealt with the whole back end of puberty, I guess you could say. And then...
you're lucky I'm not a type A personality.
And then...
because then what would you do?
And then... you have to, of course, live with the monthly visits from Aunt Hilda. And then you have to deal with pregnancy. And then you have to deal with after pregnancy. And then, for some reason, you decide, well, you know what? It was so much fun this first time. Let's do it again. So you do pregnancy again. And then after that, we deal with after pregnancy. And then we deal with the big M.
No, before that is perimenopause.
Whatever. Well,
So you have a P word.
You want to know what we did this week? We spent time at the emergency room.
Again, I'm not a type A personality.
I'm just saying,
don't stress over things. I don't get aggravated over things. I understand that,
but we spent time. Now, emergency care has gone
down the drain.
So Koffee here comes home last week from school, and her face is numb. Her neck is numb. Her hand
is numb. The whole left side of my body was tingly and numb.
Now, if this was me, that would be totally normal because my left side of my face is always paralyzed. My hand doesn't have a whole lot of feeling. And you would just say...
and now, the night before, I wasn't feeling great either. I didn't feel good when I went to sleep that night.
But if it was me, I would have said, you know
what? So I woke up the next day and I went to work and I figured, it's fine. There's nothing wrong. I'm going to work. Well... I was scared by other people, not so much by myself.
Freaking Sandy, she scared you.
She did scare me.
Anyway,
I thought I was having a stroke.
So our adventure begins at 11:30 in the morning when she comes home and we go to the Medi Center. And we get there, and I swear to God, it was like Halloween. People are
Walking Dead.
People are laying next to each other. They didn't even know each other. They're leaning on each other there. You go up to the window. It's going to be
a lot of flu and illness right now.
So, like, this is the exact place I wanted to be, is to go into this cesspool.
Obviously not. Nobody wants to be there.
And they tell her, well, it's a minimum of 2 hours.
To be seen. So when I have a stroke in the middle of the lobby, nobody seemed to care.
And she says, well, we might as well wait. I said, wait, why don't we call the doctor first? So we called the doctor. And if I was on the other line listening to what she told the nurse at the doctor's office.
But it's exactly what I was feeling.
Shout out to Lois, who answered the phone. And She then tells her, well, I'm standing next to her, and I'm thinking, oh, great, we're going to the emergency room. Now, worse than a medi center is the ER. Well, my face hurts, and my neck hurts, and I have no feeling in my hand, and my leg hurts, and I've been out of breath.
Thought I was having a stroke.
So what do you think happened?
Went to the emergency room.
Now, this is even crazier here. The only good thing about the hospital is you don't have to wear a mask. Crazy, right? You don't have to wear a mask, which is fine with me. I don't care. I've had all my vaccines. But
the only physical touch I had by anybody was a blood pressure.
Well, you got to explain going in there. Again, you know, we go in.
It really wasn't that busy, which is what I don't understand. It really wasn't crazy.
You give them their information and they tell you to go sit and looking around us. And of course, you know, you're wondering how long have these people been sitting here?
Oh, yeah. Some of them were there a long
so
time.
So our only interaction with the person is they call her back. Jennifer, go back there. Took her blood pressure, asked her if she was vaccinated.
Now, wait a minute. Let me just say four people fired questions at me from all directions.
So I was answering questions.
At the same time, they were taking my blood pressure. It was very...
So we were back there for all of about 5 minutes tops.
Correct.
And then they send us back out. All the time, in my mind, I'm thinking... This has to do something with menopause.
Be quiet.
Okay. I'm looking it up on my phone as we sit there because
I'm getting a headache just talking about this again.
And did you think I wasn't going to talk about this?
I know you were going to, but it's still I'm giving me up, and my eyes even starting to twitch again.
And every time I talk about it, it says, how old is the woman? And I put in 49 and she goes, and it comes menopause. And I put in menopause. And we took her blood pressure before she went. It was normal. We took
It was up and down. So it was high in the morning, and then it dropped down.
At the hospital,
and then it went
at the hospital,
and then it came down.
At the hospital, it was 118 over 80. So the blood pressure was normal. She even did a little EKG on her in the car. Anyway, we go for an X-ray.
So smartwatches do lots of things these days.
They realized that she wasn't dying, and we go for an X-ray.
And they said they thought I had a pinched nerve.
Right. So we get the X-ray.
No, there is no way in my mind I even thought I had a pinched nerve.
We get the X-ray, and the X-ray is
after waiting an hour, they send us for an X-ray.
Right. So then we sit there for 2 hours waiting for an X-ray result, only to come out and tell us, you need a CAT scan. Great, we need a CAT scan. Let's do it. Then we sit for 2 more hours waiting for the CAT scan.
Still have never gone in the back and haven't seen a doctor or a physician's assistant or a nurse practitioner
best, this is the best part. A woman comes out.
Take 2 Tylenol.
Jennifer, come in here. So we go into this room there where they register people. Everything's negative. It's probably menopause and
stress. They actually didn't say that. They actually said it's probably a panic attack or an anxiety attack.
And I said...
Probably related to menopause.
Exactly.
Again, how could they have known that? They never took a blood test. They never did an EKG.
And all that's going through my mind, too, is, I love this woman to death. And the whole thing I'm thinking about, oh, my God. Who's going to do my medicine at the end of the week?
There's 49-year-old women that are still having children.
And then
it's not probable, but it is possible.
Then I'm thinking.
So they did not even check my hormone levels.
Who's going
to
wrap all the presents for Christmas?
Whether I was in menopause or not.
And then I'm like, she still didn't tell me how to make her chicken soup.
Nope, not ever telling
me. And then
me.
In my mind, I'm thinking.
Now it's a secret.
I'm going to need to get not another woman. I'm just going to need a personal assistant. I was thrilled. I love you dearly.
No, I didn't want anything to be wrong.
Now, we got to say we had fun at the emergency room.
Well, I don't know if I'd say fun.
Now, the nurse came out at one time.
We did and goes, keep ourselves amused.
Nurse comes out at one time. This is like 2.5 hours in. Patricia, I said the coroner picked her up about 2 hours ago.
The patients in the waiting room did enjoy us. We did amuse.
God.
Maybe that's something we need to do every once in a while is just go amuse the waiting room.
We're
going to
go live
in
the emergency room. And we're going to talk to these people because
this is what I don't understand.
Oh, here's the best. We didn't tell them the best. People were coming in by ambulance and they were taking them off the ambulance. They're literally lifting the stretcher up and the person, boof, falls into a wheelchair. And then
putting him in the waiting room.
These people are dazed and confused at this point. And all of a sudden, they open their eyes and all these people are around them. Where am I? You're in the waiting room. But I came by ambulance. Doesn't matter.
But you go in the back and there's
horrible.
Like 10 people walking around laughing and joking and talking.
I mean, that's
and
the thing. Is you hear
I don't
them-
understand what they're doing. I realize I'm sure they're busy. I'm sure they're doing their job.
We could thank
I realize that, you know, they're shorthanded like everybody else. And I said, I get all that. They work very hard. I'm not just.
We could, you know, we could blame this on. We could blame this on the panic of the freaking COVID that they started firing everybody at the hospitals because you didn't get the vaccine that didn't prevent you from getting COVID. However, they wanted you to get the vaccine just in case. Got rid of all these people. Now they're begging them all to come back, and the people are giving them a middle finger and saying, no, we're not coming back.
Now, the people I will say that I did talk to, the x-ray technician was very friendly.
They were all nice.
And wonderful. The CAT scan people were very kind and friendly and very good with everything. I can't complain about people's attitudes or behaviors, but there has to be a better system. I don't understand. There has to be a better way.
You think?
I said, and then, you know, we add everything else that comes along the line with everybody in the, I don't know.
And
there has to be a better way.
And of course, I'm thinking the whole time, next time we'll be in a hospital, I'm having surgery number 91. And the whole time I could think about myself is like, am I going to get to 100 or you think I'll be dead before I hit 100? Because I could probably think of like 8 more things I could have surgery on before I die.
You probably could. I'm sure you could. We have a party when you hit 100? Because nowadays you have parties for things like that.
You never
right?
know.
Don't people today like throw parties for?
They do.
For everything?
They do. You never know.
So maybe we need to throw a party for 100.
It could very well be a party when I want to get my next surgery.
Do you think like the hospital might like give you a present or something?
That's funny. All right, let's move on.
Okay.
We don't say Merry Christmas or Happy Holidays. We like our old Italian Christmas, the old Italian way.
Hey!
So when you sit on Santa's lap and make your Christmas wishes, my aunts are in the kitchen cooking up the 7 fishes. Bon Natale.
I gotta say, as an Italian, I am thrilled that we don't do the 7 fishes. Could you picture us having to eat 7 different fishes?
We don't like one fish.
Oh my God.
Yuck. We do fish sticks, and that's about enough for us.
You know, and I take a little piece of the fish stick. That's all I'll take because...
I like fish sticks.
Oh, disgusting. By the way, this week on Decades, we have our Christmas Spectacular. Christmas music all night. Koffee here will be here. Me and Sam will be singing.
Of course I will.
Shadow Steele, if he could get up here to record for during the event later on, he'll be here. And, of course, Johnny Mathis will be here, and Santa Claus will be here. And we might have some time for music in between.
Maybe a little.
Now that I'm thinking of all those different things, I'm looking at my show prep to see if anything. Somebody else. Who died last week? Somebody else died. We had Bob from Sesame Street, Christine McVie, Irene Cara,
Kirstie Alley.
Oh, Kirstie Alley died.
Kirstie Alley.
Now nobody else has perished
that we know of.
Nobody big. That was my yawn. We have to start doing this earlier because...
Well, when is earlier?
I have no idea.
We're not home early.
By the way, any TikTokers, a new bill would ban TikTok in the United States, and lawmakers say it's necessary to protect America's data. What are these kids going to do when they cannot dance on TikTok?
I don't know what they're going to do. There'll have to be another platform that'll come out.
Oh, my God. What can't we...
Well, now they're goofing around with Be Real. That's the new one.
Yeah, I know. As they're all walking behind me taking pictures.
The best is when they hand you your camera and they ask you to take their picture, and it takes a picture of you instead of
yeah,
them.
Yeah, it's great. They're wonderful. They're wonderful children.
And you fall for it all the
time. I don't know. What people always ask me the same thing. I say I coach, and I say, what do you coach? 9th grade basketball. Oh, boys? No, girls. Ugh. They always give the moan that I have like, you know, 13 and 14 year old girls.
Same thing when I say I teach math, I get the same groan.
Because I get the look like, oh my God. And like tonight at practice, they all gave me that look the whole night.
You did get the death stare all night tonight.
Good God. All right. Since Christmas is coming.
And we are very excited to talk about some of the most popular gifts that people may be giving this
now,
year.
Now, you told me just recently, you're all done, but you said you want a bread maker.
I didn't say I want a bread maker. You were watching. No, wait. You were watching Little House on the Prairie, and you said, "Why don't you make me bread?"
Because
and I said, "Because when we had a fire 21 years ago, we lost our bread maker."
And
in
I
the
said,
fire,
"I'll get you
and
a new
we
bread
never
maker.
Got a new one." And I said, "Don't. I'm not
the
making
other
bread.
Thing." I was very
we
hurt
don't
of,
eat bread.
I was very hurt about today. As the Sam sends me a TikTok or something, a reel of. A man that's standing looking for something to get for Christmas. Everything is bought. Just his wife, he needs something. And he's looking at the jewelry case and he picks out a heart necklace. And the woman's like, "Oh, great. Another heart necklace." So apparently guys like to buy heart necklaces. I've never bought one.
Oh, I have about 4 or 5. It's the only one. I did say, if you are going to buy me a necklace this year, please don't make it a heart. I did say that.
She doesn't like the turtlenecks. She doesn't like the heart necklaces.
No, I didn't say any of that. See, Kramer here likes, when he finds something he knows I like, he doesn't buy me one or even two. He'll buy 5 or 6 of the exact same
thing. I bought you an iWatch.
In all different colors.
I bought you an iWatch. Oh, yes. 3 of them, but they were all new versions yes. of them. You know, if you don't,
when you find something you know I like, you buy multiples.
All I
of
want
them.
To do is give to you.
Yes, I understand that.
And you
that,
just
but,
don't want any part of it.
No, that's not true.
So anyway, the most popular Christmas gifts
that of 2022 that we are excited to see, but he keeps hiding from me.
Number one, a rechargeable hand warmer. Now 20% off at Amazon. Really? I would never get you a rechargeable hand warmer. That's stupid.
Why?
A 100% pure mulberry silk pillowcase.
I have a silk pillowcase. I don't like it.
I got you that last year. The original reversible octopus plushie. Is this really what people are looking for at Christmas?
Our kids both have them. They like them.
The mini pocket projector.
I'm not a pocket one.
You could easily connect it to your iPhone or Android phone to watch a movie.
On a big screen, it has a built-in rechargeable battery and a speaker.
Yeah, but how well does it work?
I don't know. And how big does it project it?
$220, by the way.
Wow, it's really tiny.
It is. It's handheld.
That's pretty neat.
A Yui? What is that? A Yui plus self-heating mug.
A self-heating mug.
What is the Yui?
I think it's just the kind of mug it is.
A Yui?
Yeah, like
or is it a UI?
I just think it's the type of
or
mug
is it an Ohm?
I'm not sure, but
no idea.
It's pretty cool to have that heated mug because I drink my coffee cold most of the time because by the time I get back to it, it's ice cold.
The classic Ultra Mini.
That's an UGG boot.
Oh, it's an UGG boot. They're ugly. UGG boots are ugly.
And I think both of our kids asked for them.
And they're ugly.
They're ugly, but yes. But
is that why they call them UGGs? Because they're ugly?
But they're very warm and comfortable.
The 3-in-1 charging station for your accessories.
Which is great to have all in one place. To have it, a phone, watch, AirPods.
A mushroom mug. Now that looks interesting. A mushroom mug. Lamps, candles, coffee mugs, mushrooms are in and we're here for it. Created to resemble a shit take mushroom.
No, shiitake.
It's a shit take mushroom.
It's a shiitake mushroom.
This cute mug is perfect for chefs. Foodies or anyone who likes unique presents, plus the mushroom top lid will help keep the beverage warm.
I don't like
warm.
Mushrooms. I wouldn't want to look at one on my coffee. I don't know about that.
Cloud slides.
They're comfortable.
Peel and reveal lip stain.
Interesting.
The Echo Dot.
We like our Echo Dot.
This is gross. This car cleaning gel. Apparently you put this gel
it's
all
pretty
over
cool. the- And you lift it up. It's like Silly Putty.
I know, but why can't you just get a towel and wipe it off?
It actually works really well. You use it on your keyboard, on your computer, and
the Series 7 Apple Watch. Oh, I wonder who got one of those early because they opened their present when they should have opened it.
Oh, and good thing I did.
Good thing you did.
Because the watch was missing.
The Royal Radiance Duo. I guess this is this spice?
No, it's a perfume.
Oh, I've never gotten you perfume. I used to get you Love Baby Soft every year.
Yes, you used to. And you stopped, thankfully.
Because, again, I got you too many, right? Every year, I figured once a year, wouldn't you want Love's Baby Soft? Until the one year she opens the cabinet and there's like 17 Love Baby Soft sitting there in front of her.
Well, I don't wear a lot of perfume because it bothers you and others around me. So I don't use it a lot.
What else is here? The shape-shifting box. Did you see what that clown Sammy bought for Chris?
Don't say it.
Oh my God. She is out of control. Oh, look.
Don't say that either.
Sorry.
That's a common present.
This magnetic knife block looks dangerous.
Look at that. It's just magnetic.
It doesn't go in the holes. You don't put it in the hole. Well, you put it on the side.
It's bad for your knives to stick them in those wood blocks.
Oh, well.
A lot of people are reading that book. It's a really popular book this year.
A hair dryer brush.
Oh, that's pretty cool, isn't it?
A cocktail, smoking, and infusion kit. Take their bartending skills to the next level with this best-selling smoking torch kit.
They use it all the time on like the cooking shows.
A moon lamp?
I can't imagine I've ever used it.
Oh, imagine this. A single-use camera. For a while, Polaroid cameras and the Fujifilm Instax have been all the rave. But now disposable cameras are making a comeback. Teens are just discovering the allure of capturing film photography with single-use cameras like this Kodak lens.
Did you not want to go back to single-use cameras? Oh, my God. That is no...
Crazy.
The bad pictures we'd get.
Now, this is another one. These are top-selling toys, gifts, whatever. The number one top toy for 2022 is the Air Titans Jurassic World inflatable T-Rex.
Is that like the costume you wear, or is it something you control?
Something like that. No, it looks like something you control.
It looks like, yeah.
It's an inflatable T-Rex RC, so it's a remote control RC.
Crazy.
Top tech gift is the UFI. Is that right? UFI Boost IQ Robo Vac.
It's the vacuums that are robots. The robot vacuums.
The best advent calendar is the Beanbox 12 Mornings of Koffee advent calendar.
Our daughter has the Keurig.
Of course she does.
24 days of Christmas.
Then there's the,
oh, she's driving us crazy.
Then there's
it.
The Neiman Marcus Beauty advent calendar.
Ooh.
Oh, you want one?
No, look at the cost of it.
Yeah, that's a lot. Best gifts for dad. A putt about par 3 putting green.
You're in a putting green for your back room?
I want to golf.
Where would you put it?
I don't know, but I want to golf.
Are we going to learn to golf in retirement?
I want to go. I'm great at mini golf.
Are we going to learn to golf in retirement?
I don't think
you'd be able to do it.
I'd hurt my face.
Yeah, I think you would.
And I'm pretty sure I'd hit somebody.
You might hurt yourself like you did tonight.
I ball tap myself with my phone. I was talking about something. I get very excited.
I can't imagine that with a golf club in hand. You wouldn't hurt yourself.
I get very excited when Little House on the Prairie's on and I was saying something and I took my phone and I went to put it up my side and I didn't. Oh my God.
He dropped to the ground.
That
instantly.
Hurt. Best gifts for husbands. The SoundBot. Water resistant Bluetooth 3.0 shower speaker. I have no interest in that.
You don't like to listen to music in the bathroom?
I guess I do.
You listen to music all the time in the bathroom.
I listen to Dr. Laura in the bathtub.
Well, but you listen to something in the bathroom all the time.
Best gift for boyfriends, Outdoor Voices men's cloud knit slim sweatpants.
Look at the cost of sweatpants.
$60. Best gift for brothers, the 12 South Airfly Pro, whatever that is.
I'm not sure what that
is. It's the handy Bluetooth adapter will allow them to connect AirPods or other wireless headphones to an aux cable. Like an airplane's onboard system for a better all-around user experience. So they don't hand out those disgusting headphones anymore?
Oh, God, no.
We haven't flown since 2005?
Something like that.
We're gonna get on. Maybe we're going to get on a plane this summer.
Yeah, okay. Sure, we will.
Why? I want to travel somewhere.
Where you want to go?
Vegas.
You're not going to go to Vegas. You're not going to go on a plane. Who are you kidding?
We went to Vegas twice.
I know. You're not getting on a plane. Who are you kidding?
Why? I don't mind a plane. Now that you don't have to wear masks, it doesn't bother me. I was not getting on a plane with a mask on for 5 hours.
With the delays and with the canceled flights.
No, everything's pretty back to normal now. They said there's no... Thanksgiving was very good. They said everything is pretty much back to normal.
Okay, I'll believe it when I see it.
I would. I would love to go somewhere. I won't go to California because I couldn't stand the libs being in California. And Florida, nice red state. However...
It's too hot.
Too hot.
Muggy.
Yeah, I don't want to go from here... In the summer to Florida in the summer.
I would like to see Tennessee.
I'd like to go to
Tennessee
Alaska.
Tennessee looks like a lot of fun.
What else? And I ain't getting honest. I was thinking of an Alaskan cruise until that ship up there got hit by a rogue wave and like 10 people fell out into the water. And
what's the other word that you've been having a hard time saying lately?
I don't know. Oh, See? Ammunition. Ammunition.
You're still not saying it
right. I need the ammunition for...
No, you're still saying it wrong.
You're
using too many syllables.
Ammunition.
See? You can't say it.
There's some things you can't say either.
So. What else? There's lots of words.
Best grooming gifts. An algae body oil. What the...
Is that for men?
I don't know what you do with that. Uh-oh. His razor and shaving. I don't use razor and shaving cream, so. Best gifts for her. The best gifts for moms are Bala bangles.
That's a bracelet.
I've never heard of it.
It's not even an attractive bracelet. I don't know.
Best gifts for wives, a bamboozy. Yeah. Bamboozy. It's not a bamboozy. It's a bamboozy store bamboo bathtub caddy tray. Are you really going to use that in the bathtub?
No, I would never.
You have enough
use
trouble
it.
Maneuvering in there as it is.
I have one of those back pillows for your head. I don't use that.
And you don't let me join me in the tub anymore.
I don't sit in there long enough. I say, get in, I get out. I
say,
do
you want me
to
get in the tub with you? No.
No. I lock the door and have quiet time. That's the best time of the day.
Totally ignore me. Best gifts for girlfriends. Dame fin? What the hell is a dame fin?
You better read before you say
whether
it,
it has been 3 months or 3 years, shopping for a thoughtful gift for your special someone requires some digging. If you're looking to spice things up, this small dame...
Yeah, I said you better read it before you say it.
The dame fin.
You better think about it before you say it.
Making it great for couples play or for them to use it solo. Why would I want to give my girlfriend something to use solo?
It says it's good for play. Couples play.
Do you want a dame thing?
No, I...
Now I'm getting ideas here.
No, I don't. I don't even understand what it is from the picture.
Why doesn't that say best gifts for wives? Because you don't have sex after you get married? Is that what it says means?
I don't know.
And imagine, is it your personal dame Finn, or do you, like, pass it on?
I don't think you pass things like that on, Joe.
Best gifts for sisters, a dame Finn. That would
be bad. Get that for your $5 exchange.
5-minute journal is the best gift for sisters. Best gifts for mother-in-law, an Ara Carver smart digital picture frame. Best gifts for pregnant women. This is going to be good. I can't wait to see this. The Ebby the oil. What the hell is Ebby the oil? It's just...
An electric massager. It's oil to put on your stomach to help with stretch marks.
So you want me to...
And then use a massager on that area.
And Neil Diamond was... So, no, not Neil Diamond. Nell Diamond.
Oh, my goodness.
We need to switch seats because...
He's having a hard time speaking and reading tonight.
Best gifts for new mom, the Cara baby bag. $318?
That's...
Are you kidding me?
Costs of things. I don't know what list you're looking at. This. Look at that papa.
The best gift for six-month-olds is a Razza Baby, Razza Berry silicone baby teether toy.
It looks like a scary pacifier.
Yeah, that is. Best gifts for one-year-olds, boon pipes. They look like... They look like...
You attach it to the wall in the bathtub, and they make the water go through, and you can play with it.
They look like bongs. The bong in the bathroom. 2-year-olds, your Melissa and Douglas playhouse. Is it a dust sweep mop 6-piece pretend?
You would have loved that.
I need that now. The original plasma car for the best gifts for 3-year-olds. Whether it's using indoors or outdoors, this plasma car will get your toddler moving.
I don't see a lot of people buying that for their 3-year-olds.
I did see kids, you know those cars that we had like when we were young with the red tops and the, what were they called? And the yellow bottoms.
You buy we talked kids? About from Fisher Price. We from talked Fisher about Price. Them.
Well,
yeah.
The new trend on TikTok is teenagers are putting a helmet on and they're getting inside and then they're.
Of course they are.
Their friends push them towards the curb and they flip over.
Of course they do. Why does that not surprise me at all?
I enjoyed it. Mm. 5-year-olds, telescopes. Best gift for 6-year-olds. Cameras. 7-year-olds, Blockus strategy game. 8-year-olds, Crayola, paper, and crap. I'm glad we don't have to get this stuff anymore. This like gives every age. What is it? Every single age you get a different...
I guess.
Tween boys, the 3 Dueler Start Essential 3D pen.
Those are really cool. I've played with them before.
Nowadays, preteen boys want a vape.
Yeah, I don't know, but yeah, they're pretty cool.
Oh, this Magnolorian LED photo string lights for teen girls.
That's like for a dorm room.
Teen Boys, the Nelsy Sunstrit Lamp Protection.
Projection.
Video games like the latest Madden game or Call of Duty might be on your teen boy's holiday list, but if he's satisfied with his current game collection, this TikTok-approved sunset lamp, as seen in our latest teen poll, will embrace his bedroom gaming setup with 16 different colors.
What teen boy is satisfied with their gaming collection?
When I was a teen boy, that wasn't what I wanted to put on my walls.
That's what I'm saying.
I had Samantha Fox.
Who are they going to put up now?
Samantha Fox and her
Taylor
big
Swift?
Old gajangas. What's that? Taylor Swift.
That's what I'm saying.
Samantha.
That's my point. Why would they? Who do they have to put up now?
I know that's true. The women in the 80s were just girls, actually. And she was my age, so I can say that. I'll never forget when my mother saw Samantha Fox on my wall.
Yeah.
With very little on, actually nothing on. And that was next to that when she found the Playboys underneath my mattress. Why was I so stupid? Why do guys, especially when we were teenagers, hide our magazines with naked women underneath our mattress? Like, our mothers are never going to see them there.
Because did you make your own bed when you were a teenager? Or did your mother make your bed?
But my mother would, like, strip the bed or something.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Did your mother...
Well, that's the thing. Why did I put them underneath there?
Where else would you hide them?
I'm just...
Your mother looked everywhere. Your mother looked in the trash.
Your grandfather gave me all of his Playboys.
He did.
Which I probably should have saved. A lot of those would probably be worth money.
I don't know. You yelled at us for saving old magazines. Remember? You made us get rid of them all.
It was crazy. But there you go. If you need any ideas, that's your ideas.
Most of them are not good.
Yeah.
I don't know who makes these lists, because a lot of them are not good.
All right. We're going to do one more thing before we stop tonight.
Okay.
Yeah, I know you had a list, but
that's okay. We'll save it.
This is a holiday movie, Who Wants to Be a Millionaire quiz. So see if you could win it. Here's how it works. The more questions you answer correctly, the more money you win. But they're going to get trickier and trickier as soon as you answer a question incorrectly. You're out, done, finished forever. You don't win anything, but...
We can pretend to win?
Yeah, I'm just reading what's here. All right. What is the name of Will Ferrell's character in Elf? Is it Buddy, Lorenzo, Bubbles, or Santa Jr.?
Buddy the Elf.
Is that your final answer?
That's my final answer.
All right. We should get like some Who Wants to Be a Millionaire music. Can I get that up here? Hang on. We're going to take a break second. Hold on. Talk about something.
What am I going to talk about?
I should plan more.
I don't like the movie Elf. Do you like the movie Elf?
I watched it actually the other night.
Yeah?
I really don't. It was something to fall asleep to.
Well, yeah. It's so many people watch it religiously. Like, it's one of their movies that they watch all the time.
All right. Wait. Is this it? Is this it? Oh, here it is.
Okay.
See, I got it. See, I need a producer.
You do need a producer.
You just sit here looking pretty. It's crazy.
I do the job
All right,
I'm supposed
to do.
You got the first one correct.
You got correct. You have $100.
Okay.
So, what is the correct name of the 2000 film starring Jim Carrey as the Grinch? Is it...
How the Grinch Stole Christmas.
You got to listen to the answers first.
Sorry.
You don't play anything fair.
Sorry.
How the Grinch Got His Groove Back. How the Grinch Saved Christmas. How the Grinch Stole Christmas. Or The Grinch A Life.
How the Grinch Stole Christmas.
How the Grinch Stole Christmas, your final answer.
Correct.
You are correct. Okay, so you got $200. In Love Actually, one character confesses something to another with cue cards. What was he confessing? He doesn't remember her name and he feels it's too late to ask. He actually hates Christmas. He's her long lost twin brother. Or he's in love with her.
He's in love with her.
Final answer?
Yes.
Woo, you're right. You're getting good with this.
Mm-hmm.
What is the title of the movie that Kevin fools the delivery driver with in Home Alone? The movie within the movie. All right? Devils with Good Intentions. Angels with Missing Wings. Angels with Filthy Souls. Or Saints with Good Ideas.
I just remember them saying, "Keep the change, you filthy animals."
And what movie was it?
Was it Angels with Filthy Souls?
It was Angels with Filthy Souls.
There we go.
In A Christmas Story, Ralphie's father wins a lamp. What is it shaped like? A woman's leg, a Christmas tree, a woman's arm, or a dress? You better know this.
Gee, I don't know. A woman's leg.
Who plays Scrooge in The Muppet Christmas Carol? Whoa! Was it Tom Hanks?
No.
Was it Michael Gambon?
don't know who any of those people
are. Was it Ian McKellen or was it Michael Caine?
Is it Michael Caine? Because I don't think
it is Michael Caine. $4,000.
Ooh.
Which writer is the man who invented Christmas about? The man who invented Christmas. For $4,000. Is it Herman Melville? Is it Charles Dickens? Is it Walt Whitman or is it Edgar Allan Poe?
I would say Charles Dickens, but I'm not.
Charles Dickens. I was right. If I wasn't helping her right now, she would be out already.
No, that's what my guess was.
In which month was The Miracle on 34th Street released?
When was it released?
Was it December?
That would make sense.
Was it January? Was it March? Or was it June?
The most logical would be December.
Is that your final answer?
Go ahead. See, I told you. I told you that was a trick.
It was June. It was.
See, December makes sense, but I knew that was going to be a trick.
You know, did you know
that answer?
Yes, I did know that answer, but we're running out of time, and I didn't want to do it anymore.
Okay.
So, that was that.
That was that.
Now I got to figure out how to get rid of this millionaire music that's playing here. All right, we got
close
we
it
got,
out.
We got rid of that. That's gone. So, what are we going to do now to get out of here? I got to find a song.
Oh, gosh.
Wait. You talk a little bit.
Talk a little bit.
So I just had it. Now I lost it.
We still have lots to do before the Christmas season, you realize.
I have nothing to do. All of our presents are
bought. Well, you took care of ordering everything.
I bought every single present this Christmas.
But in our hiding spot.
Every Christmas.
Everything is just in a big, massive pile and has to be separated
and
organized and wrapped
and whose fault is that?
All that. And I already made one batch of cookies that is already gone.
I have no
idea
who did that.
There's no way
that
cookies will make it till Christmas. I'll have to make a second batch.
You know what this is?
What is this?
This is the Macarena Christmas.
Oh my gosh. Only you find songs
like
this.
These are songs you only hear on Decades, but I've taken care of Christmas last year, and I took care of Christmas this year.
You do just the part of going online and ordering. Everything then is left towards me.
I'm
the
just
tree,
saying.
The presents, the baking, all that stuff all falls on me.
Last year, I took
the
care
last
of
minute
all,
stuff.
I took care of all Christmas because you were on crutches. And again, this year I did. So.
You didn't. No, you can't say you took care of all Christmas.
I took care of all Christmas.
No.
All right. Don't forget to join us Saturday for the big Christmas show. We'll have this man on. Johnny Mathis will be with us. Plus, Shadow Steele will be here. Jennifer Koffee will be here. Sam will be here. Santa Claus will be here. And hopefully we'll be back before Christmas. But just in case, have a Merry Christmas. And Happy New Year.
Happy Hanukkah. Happy everything.
We might be back.
Enjoy your breaks.
I'm thinking we're going to do a Christmas Eve show. So
Christmas Eve,
I think.
Oh.
I'm Joey Kramer.
And I'm Jennifer Koffee.
And this is
Koffee and Kramer.
Somebody waits for you. Kiss her once for me. Have a holly jolly Christmas. And in case you didn't hear, by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year.